most of you all who are interested in solar are probably aware of the federal tax credits that are available currently and through 2022. Through the balance of this year, through the balance of this year, the ITC, the federal tax credit, is 30%. There is a new program out that was just put out about 3 or 4 months ago called Safe Harbor. That is from the Internal Revenue Service. If you have up to 5% of your system installed or begun before the end of this calendar year, before January 1st, 2020, you can continue to take the 30% credit moving forward through 2024. Now, the whole reason this came about is there are so many large-scale megawatt size arrays and this type of thing that are being installed, large corporate systems. You don't do those, you don't even design those systems in a month. It can take a year or more to put those systems together. So several people that were in process were going to lose that 30%. So the federal government stepped up and said, hey, we'll work with you on this. This has been set all the way down to the homeowner level now. So if you're considering doing solar, and I can tell you our company right now is beginning to book 2020 already. We're not totally booked out for this year, but we're heading that way quickly. We're actually starting another crew here in just a couple weeks to continue moving forward as fast as we can. But the other side of this is individuals who are close to that timeline, whether we're installing a system for you or another installer, talk to them about that timetable. It's really important that you do that. One other thing, also contact your current, your local federal legislator, whether it's U.S. House representatives or your local senator, U.S. senator. Contact them and ask them to support the extension of the tax credits. There is a movement, a very large movement, going on right now in D.C. To have the federal tax credits extended another 5 years. It's gaining traction. Since they began this program 13 years ago at this point, the U.S. has created over 350,000 jobs in the solar industry. It's a major employer at this point from that standpoint. There are a number of states, a number of legislators that are making a big push to see this continued forward. There's also a push forward right now to get battery systems included in the 30%. Right now that does not exist. That program is also gaining a great deal of traction. So, you know, contact your legislators, ask them to support those programs. I want to say one other thing, since Fitz isn't here right now, and I know he would be, oh, yes, he is. There's Fitz. I didn't see him back there. I'm not going to talk about Senate Bill 100 because I know he's going to do that for you. So that's it. If you have any other further questions, please don't hesitate to ask after we get out in the other room after a while. Thank you. Thanks, Carmen.